Hello, welcome back to Fish Terminology segment. In today's episode, we're going to look at another 5 fish terminology beginning with the letter D. The first terminology is dermal denticle. Denticle is translated into a fine tooth. In fish, it is commonly found with the word dermal denticle. What is dermal denticle? It is actually associated with placoid scales in cartilaginous fish. Dermal denticle, which is structurally similar with the vertebrate teeth, commonly found in species like shark and rays. Sharks don't have typical scales that normal bony fish does. Their skin is covered with dermal denticle, giving it a rough feel when you run your finger on their skin. This type of scale is a great material to reduce turbulence and drag, making shark one of a great swimmer. Hence, mini swimsuits were designed to replicate this material to help swimmers glide through the water faster. However, unlike other types of scales that grow larger over the time, dermal denticles will stop growing once reaching a certain size, but more denticles are added as the fish grows. The second terminology is the dorsal fin. This is the type of fin located on the back of the fish body. Normally, most fish possess only one dorsal fin, but in certain species, more than one or two dorsal fins are required. For example, shark and yellowfin tuna have two dorsal fins, while haddocks have three. The main function of the dorsal fin is for stability, mainly for making a sudden turn. Without the dorsal fin, fish might be easily rolled over and will have difficulties if they plan to spin swiftly. In some species, dorsal fin helps for propulsion function such as sunfish. Not to mention, some use it for the fishing pole to lure their prey such as anglerfish. The third terminology is DISCUS. DISCUS is a species of fish under the genus of Symphysodon, who is native to the Amazon River. They are well known amongst the ornamental freshwater fish hobbies due to their distinctive shape and bright colors. DISCUS has literally compressed this shaped body with brightly marked vibrant colors across their body. They could grow up to 15 cm in length, with male grow larger than female. Although these herbivorous fish could play well with other fishes' inmates, they are not suitable for first-timer fish keepers. They require stable water parameters, spacious tanks, and high quality of feed. The fourth terminology is demersal. The word demersal, derived from the word demergir, means to sink. It refers to species living near the seafloor and lake beds. The fishes within the demersal zone have a heavier weight than the water and neutral buoyancy to float just above the substrate. Demersal is the contrast to the pelagic, who wander around the open ocean column. Some species could be a predominantly pelagic, but spawn and breed near the seabed such as Atlantic herring. Demersal fish can be divided into two types, the benthic organisms who rest on the seafloor and the benthopelagic who float near the water column. Flatfish, stingrays, turbot, halibut are those who thrive living in the demersal zone. The last terminology is diadromous, which is generally described as fish who could spend portions of their life in freshwater and another part in saltwater. This could apply to both fish in anadromous and catadromous categories. Anadromous were born in freshwater and migrate to saltwater to spend most of their life there before returning to freshwater to spawn. Such species including salmon, striped bass and sturgeon. While catadromous is the other way around, whereby they were born in saltwater, migrate to freshwater and return to saltwater to reproduce. Eels is the best known group belong to the catadromous category. Well, that's all 5 terminologies that you should know, beginning with the letter D. If you like this video, please leave a thumbs up and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Until then, thanks for watching and see you next time.